across the town, all across the night. Everybody's driving with four headlights. Black or white, you're turning on your face of new religion. Everybody's sitting around watching television.
Clash. Now, along with the Sex Pistols, they were one of the first British punk bands from 1976, and last night they played the Assembly Rooms in Derby. Now, personally, I thought they lacked the old drive and energy and sounded a bit worn out, so it's a good job I didn't interview them after the gig, because I might have given them a bit of stick. However, Clash enthusiast Haddon Smith went backstage to interview the Clash for Barbed Wireless, but it seemed that Mick Jones wanted to do all the talking, and he thought the Clash had seen some real sight since last playing in Derby.
Yeah, we've been all over the place since then.
Yeah, you went to Thailand, Bangkok. Do the people know all your stuff down there?
Everywhere. Okay. Yeah, we were number one there. We've never been number one here.
Do you think that there's some fear, though, if you keep going, it's like it's 2 years since your last British tour, that you're going to go away to America somewhere and maybe not come back for 6 years and play Earl's Court like the Stones or something?
We haven't done that yet. We've been going for 6 years and we've done a tour every year in England, if not two tours at least, right? So there is no comparison. So I'll answer that question categorically, no. But don't stop us going places where they like us better than they like us here, right?
Yeah.
When we're number one somewhere, we're really glad to be number one, right? Because when we're not number one here, it's humiliating for us when we see a load of shit number one, right? We feel like, why ain't we there? Right, and if we can be number one somewhere else, then great.
Joe Strummer looked a bit worn out tonight.
Yeah, we've been better. We have been better. I think it was his voice. He was lying in one of these rooms, right, and the air conditioning was on.
Yeah.
And this really seriously affects his voice, right? And he fell asleep, and he woke up, and he was freezing. And his voice had, like, stiffed out halfway through the show. You know, I did a lot of backing vocals and stuff to try and compensate. We have been better. You know, and it was just a misfortunate accident.
What do you think of Derby then? Because
always encountered, like, last time we played here, it was like very violent, and the time before that, I believe it was very violent.
At the King's Hall, that was.
So, yeah, so this time it's been non-violent, and it's been an occasion to celebrate, as opposed to saying, oh my God, you know. You know, we don't want to come up there and, like, watch a lot of guys fight. You know what I mean? I've seen better fighters in the end of my street than, really, you know what I mean? Or I'll go and see a real fight, a boxing fight, you know?
So you condemn violence your actions and,
totally.
And by the lyrics?
You know, we play energetic music, which, yes, condemns violence as stupidity.
It wasn't the early days of punk known as punk and violence.
Well,
loud music.
That's like, this is a misconception, you see. Like, sort of groups that were all invented spitting, invented the violence bit as well, you know what I mean, that went along with
it. So you've been opposed to both all the way along?
Yeah, always. You know what I mean? It's a misconception to lump us in with the spitting punks.
The Clash, who aren't spitting punks or violent, hence their first single, White Riot.
Thank you.
Kosmo, a lot of people at Radio Derby want to know why you said that we'd have to come to you and you didn't want to come to us, because originally, I think it's Tim Parsons said that you would come to us, but then when Joe went away for his little holiday and then came back, maybe you didn't need the publicity.
Joe ran away. He ran away because he couldn't take it anymore.
Yeah, okay.
Well, right, he didn't go on holiday. We've never had a holiday for the 6 years we've been doing it, except for the week when Paul was in hospital in Bangkok, which could be considered a holiday. But apart from that, we don't have them.
But why were you originally prepared to come to Radio Derby and then we've had to come down here tonight?
You were misinformed by somebody who doesn't decide for the clash, you know? MCP
doesn't. Or whinging. I mean, you know, man, we're here. You can get an interview now. Ask your questions. Don't ask why we couldn't make it to the last time. You know, now is the moment. Seize that moment. You know, as if it was the power that you were looking for. As if it was radio big shit. Is there a little one?
But you'd go to Radio 1, but you...
Yeah, we do, because we need to be played on Radio 1 badly, because we need to be up there and not down here, right? No, I'm not talking about physically in Derby. Yeah. I'm talking about, like, number 38 as opposed to number 2 or number 1, right? Even number 2 don't please us, you know what I mean? We're sitting around going, well, why are we number 38? It's because they don't play us on the radio. Radio 1 all over the bloody country, right? If we can get on the radio, then great. That's right, we'll go and crawl a little bit. We don't crawl anyway. You know what I mean? We're nice. We're nice guys. We get along fine. You know, Kid James plays a record great. You know what I mean? He invites us every time we have a record out.
Yeah, and you right? haven't got to number 2, was it? You?
Yeah.
Combat Rock.
I know.
That's the highest one you've had so far.
Well, yeah. Yeah, in this country. I mean, that was a gag, you know what I mean? For the week it lasted, it was real fun, you know. But it was nicer if it had been Batloaf or something, you know what I mean? Been there for years.
So you're really chuffed to be almost number 1 in your own country then?
Yeah, we were really chuffed for a week. And we were stars for a week, you know what I mean? If we'd been number 1 for a week, we would have probably been bigger.
The music press seemed to slug you off. You know,
come see. 1 week they're slagging us off, the next week they're saying how wonderful we are. You know what I mean? It only just adds to the confusion. It makes us feel confused. Best not to read it.
Really. So you don't really care what people read about you in the press?
Well, you know, they don't really know us.
So
it's hard to say.
It's obviously better if they say it's great. It's obviously better.
We prefer it, you know?
But if they say it's bad, it don't mean it's bad. See, so when they say it's good,
then personally, yeah.
When they say it's good, it's we like it, and they're usually right. So it's a good all round deal. But a lot of the time, they say it's bad. It's not bad, and the people that went didn't think it was bad. It's just some guy thought it was bad. So there's no point.
You know, very often we have a situation where we get a bad review, and it's because the guy couldn't get off with the bird he wanted to. You know what I mean? It's true. It really happens. You know what I mean? So he's in a bad mood. He's having a terrible time because this bird he's after is... I mean, this is a horrible way to talk, but this is the way people behave, right? This bird that he's chasing is going off with some other geezer, you know, and it's making him really sick. You know what I mean? So he's slagging us off or anything. You know what I mean? He might be too pissed to see straight or... You know what I mean? He might be on drugs or... Who knows? You know? It's all sorts of things. All sorts of things. You know, determine whether or not we get a good review. Nothing to do with the music half the time. I never even bother to talk about it. I'd like them to talk a bit more about the music, really. You know, I think it's what it is. It's like a lot of it is like jealousy, you know, because we're such brilliant people.
when punk came to be known by the media and everything.
Yeah.
And Joe...
Came spoilt, yes. This is
Joe says so, that he sees... 1982 punk wave was pretty much of a retread and everything. Do you share that opinion?
Not for us. For other groups, perhaps.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
For other groups, perhaps. Yeah, I think that might be true, and they do best to expand and, you know, find a direction and explode out of that restriction as soon as they can. Not for us. No.
But if you were... 18 or 19, unemployed, would you be in one of these new hardcore bands, such as Discharge or Exploited?
I don't know. No, I shouldn't think so. I mean, because we're also songwriters, as well as musicians.
You're writing a song for Janie Jones and for her to sing in...
That's right, Joe's doing that, yeah. It's about the judge that sent her down, yes.